Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. We're so excited to have you join us this afternoon for the 2021 Graduation Recognition and Awards Ceremony for the Nursing Department and Helen and Arthur E. Johnson Bethel College of Nursing and Health Sciences. We're going to recognize the achievement of the graduates of our undergraduate program options, the traditional and the accelerated options that prepare students for entry into professional nursing practice. My name is Dr. Debbie Pollard, and I have the honor and privilege to be the department chair for nursing and therefore share in the excitement of this very special day for our graduates. Even though we've had to make these special accommodations this year due to capacity limits, we are excited to be able to provide the ceremony in person and stream live for family and friends who want to share this great accomplishment with our graduates today. It just seems like yesterday that your classes participated in the white coat ceremonies, where you received your white coat and you recited your nurse's pledge. Now you've completed 800 in clinical hours, even in the time of a pandemic, and at least 127 academic credits. Again, you will recite this pledge today and receive a pin as you embark into professional nursing. I would like to take a moment to recognize a bit of our history as we recognize the graduates that came before you who are now celebrating their 25th and their 50th anniversaries of their graduations. The School of Nursing was first established in 1904 in Colorado Springs, and it wasn't until 1997 that the School of Nursing merged with UCCS. With this illustrious 117-year history, we recognize the nursing graduates celebrating their 50th anniversary of their graduation, referred to as the Golden Graduates. Now in 1971, just to give you a brief history, the School of Nursing was owned actually by the city of Colorado Springs. And so the School of Nursing was actually housed in the photo here down on Boulder. You may notice, and it may be hard to read though, but because the School of Nursing was operated by the City of Colorado Springs, there actually was an amendment proposed back in 1971 to potentially close the school. Fortunately, the residents of Colorado Springs voted to continue to support the School of Nursing. On this slide, you see the photo of the 13 graduates of the class of 1971. Priscilla Salier, Miss Ruth Gaston, Rebecca Rapp, Diana Starbuck, Kathy Barker, Maureen Stone, Leslie Neve, Fitz Rowe, Suzanne Simons, Ralph Quaid, Carolyn Clausen, Susan Roberts, and Trudy Carter. I also want to recognize the graduates of 1996 who are celebrating their 25th anniversary of their graduation. Now back then in 1996, if you remember, I said 1997 was when the School of Nursing merged with UCCS. So the class of 1996 was actually the last class 25 years ago to graduate being operated by the City of Colorado Springs. Now in this slide, you see the 78 graduates who graduated in 1996. So next, it's my distinct pleasure to introduce our Dean and Professor of Johnson Bethel, Dr. Kevin Laudner.
Dr. Pollard, faculty, staff, families, and of course, our class of 2021, thank you for the honor of speaking to you today. This is always the highlight of the academic year for me to give these remarks. But this year seems even a little bit more special than the fact that we're able to do it in person. And I know this isn't the celebration that we usually plan. A lot of your family and friends couldn't be here because of capacity issues. But this was a really big feat to put this on, to maintain social distancing. So I'd just like to acknowledge the efforts of Dr. Pollard, the faculty, and the staff in the Department of Nursing for all their efforts to make this happen today. So can we give them a round of applause? I hope this is a day you remember for the rest of your lives, because it is the beginning of another change for you. By now, you should be used to change. Remember the changes that occurred when you graduated from high school, transferred from a community college, or decided to make a career change and came to UCCS. Think back to your first week of classes. Now think about the changes that have shaped you to be the person you are today. You had so many experiences that brought on these changes at your time at UCCS. Lectures, laboratories, new friends, clinical experiences, and the list goes on. You're about to begin additional changes as you leave UCCS and start your careers as nurses. Some of you will be moving. You will begin new positions, whether it be in a hospital, a clinic, or elsewhere. You will make change happen. Change affects everyone differently. Some people fear it, some people accept it, some people thrive on it, but everyone must respond to it. My advice to you, when opportunity comes along, don't dip your toe in the water. Close your eyes, plug your nose, and do a cannonball into the deep end. Your education at UCCS has prepared you to manage this change, and you are capable of so much more than you may think. Nursing is a constantly changing profession. The educational and clinical experiences required to become a nurse have changed drastically over the years and will change even more in the future. When you thought about becoming a nurse, you probably weren't thinking about background checks, HESI exams, simulation laboratories, or the coronavirus. You probably were thinking about changing patients' lives by treating and helping them recover from illnesses like heart disease and cancer, or assisting a baby in the NICU. Change will take place regardless, but you are prepared because as nurses and UCCS graduates, you have learned to adapt to change. You will mindfully and carefully use your knowledge and clinical skills to create positive change in the world as you move forward in your chosen careers. And because of this change, you can never stop learning. As the founder of modern nursing, Florence Nightingale, once stated, "Let us never consider ourselves finished nurses. We must be learning all of our lives." And this certainly applies to you today, because graduation is not the end, it's the beginning. Your family and friends will also be going through change. They are working through changes of you graduating, whether you are the first or one of many family members who are college graduates. As you change, I hope you can take comfort in knowing that your family, friends, and everyone at UCCS will be your biggest supporters. Your family and friends have helped you throughout this journey, so please take the time to thank them for helping you through the many changes of your past, and show appreciation for the fact that they will be there for the many changes yet to come. You are the product and key to change. As you finish this chapter of your lives, embrace it. Positively change the lives of your patients, change the lives of those who you work with, change the nursing profession, change the world. On behalf of the faculty and staff and the Helen and Arthur E. Johnson Bethel College of Nursing and Health Sciences, I wish you the best of luck. And congratulations to each and every one of you in our class of 2021.
Thank you, Dean Laudner, for those thoughtful words. To begin our ceremony, I am sure that each of the graduates here today would attest to the journey to this day was not possible without the support provided by so many. So on behalf of the graduates, I would like to take a moment to recognize those who have contributed to your success. Thank you for making the dreams of achieving this degree a reality for these graduates. So first of all, family and friends. Please stand, family and friends, who have provided their unconditional love and support. The graduates, thank you. To our many scholarship donors for their generous financial support, the graduates thank you for that support. To our incredible nursing faculty, although in small numbers here today, but many of them are watching via live stream, for their enthusiasm and their passion to mentor and support our graduates to be prepared to embrace the role of the professional nurse. The faculty have especially worked hard as the students had to move to remote, to high-flex learning environments for this past year. The faculty worked tirelessly to ensure that these graduates were able to complete their program requirements on time to graduate. So, faculty here, could you please stand? To the UCCS and School of Nursing staff for their commitment to fostering all of the school activities, from admission, advising, to organizing this graduation celebration. So if I could recognize our two nursing advisors, Aaron Mitchler, there's Aaron, Andy Diamond in the back, and then our staff, Shelley Harden, you all know Shelley, Debbie Schultz and Linda Matthews for all of their assistance with making this ceremony possible. So it's my distinct pleasure and privilege to present these graduates to all of you for recognition and awards. Today, of course, we've had two ceremonies. We had a ceremony this morning and a ceremony this afternoon with a total of 120 graduates at those two ceremonies. We have 78 graduates in the traditional program option who are graduating, and 42 students in the accelerated option who will complete their program requirements in August. Now it's my honor to present the Department of Nursing Awards. Now this morning we did award some of these awards, but I'm going to announce their names again this afternoon. The first award is the Outstanding Academic Nursing Student Award. It recognizes a student in the traditional option who has achieved the highest GPA during their undergraduate studies. And actually, we had two students who tied in this high academic honor. So this year, the recipients of the Outstanding Academic Nursing Awards were Amber Galligan, and the second student who received this academic award this morning was Marie Lucero. Yeah. Now on this occasion, we also have some special honors to confer to a student from each program option who exemplifies the values of Florence Nightingale's vision for nursing. These values are leadership, a love of learning, a practice based on knowledge, compassion for others, and a commitment to the profession. Therefore, a special award, the Spirit of Nightingale Award, has been created to honor these students. This morning, we recognized a student from the traditional option, Noah Stangeby, and this afternoon we're going to recognize a student from the accelerated program option. Senior instructor Maisha Tompkins is going to come forward to present the award to this student. The recipient of the Spirit of Nightingale Award for the Accelerated Program option is Nita Saw Duncan. Nita, if you can come forward. Now I'm going to read some comments that faculty had to say about Nita. Nita participated in an undergraduate student mountain lion research day in 2020. Nita worked independently on a research project involving physical activity and mental health in adult women with heart disease. Working with mentorship from Drs. Melissa Benton and Dr. Helen Graham, Nita did a secondary analysis study, and after analyzing the results, created a presentation that was then posted for Mountain Lion Week. She volunteered to do the project, and no extra credit for her was involved. Hers was the only research project from the nursing department. In addition, Nita is the accelerated cohort representative on the Undergraduate Nursing Council. To recognize Nita for her accomplishment and her dedication to research in true Nightingale spirit. Congratulations, Nita. We also have an Outstanding Clinical Student Award, which is chosen by nomination and vote of the nursing faculty for a student with their outstanding work and their clinical experiences. As with the previous award, we will recognize a student from each program option receiving the Outstanding Clinical Award. This morning, we awarded the Outstanding Clinical Award for the traditional option to Heidi Staus. The recipient this afternoon of the Outstanding Clinical Student Award for the Accelerate Program option is Kale Johnson. Now, Kale is unable to be with us here today, but I do want to read the comments that faculty had to say about Kale. Kale has an exceptional ability to analyze and synthesize concepts and was able to apply this in the clinical setting. He demonstrates thoughtful consideration of the unique needs of the patient and integrates evidence-based practice to address the patient's care. In developing his care with his assignments, he goes above and beyond most students in researching the evidence and demonstrates that he can apply it to practice. Kale was very committed to his own growth and demonstrated significant improvement in his clinical abilities and reasoning, as well as his therapeutic support to patients. He is very respectful of the patient's beliefs and special circumstances, and thoughtful about the meaning of these beliefs in his care. Congratulations, Kale. Now I ask Senior Instructor Sue Davis to come forward, and she's going to recognize our BSNA, our Bethel Student Nurses Association.
Good afternoon. It's fine. It's good to see everybody in person. This poor accelerated class has only been virtual, except for a few classes. So it's nice to see you guys up close and personal. The BSNA stands for Bethel Student Nurses Association. And what it is, for all the family and friends that are here, is it's an organization that your student or your loved one had a choice that they could get involved with during their time here at Bethel. And what we do is we reach out to the community and do all sorts of community service projects. We do other things for the students. We had a toy drive this year that we donated toys to for at Children's Hospital for the kiddos that are patients there. And one of the things we did for the students is we held a career fair, where we had vendors come in from all the different facilities up and down the Front Range to hire your students and for them to get an opportunity to talk to recruiters and potentially get a job. And that was no small feat because of COVID. I want you to know that just like you guys, BSNA had many hurdles to climb this year. We had to do all kinds of things different, just like everybody else in the whole world is doing things different. We had to have meetings both virtual and online, and we did them at the same time. And we had to do all kinds of hoops to get things to happen. But we were one of the very few, if not the only, student organization on campus that met all year long. And we were the only group that had a major event like the career fair live, where we actually had vendors come in. I didn't want to do it virtual. So we were able to get it live, just like you are here. It was a little different, but it still happened, and so we were really grateful. So the board of directors were students that were elected a year ago March, and they are students that decided to step up to the plate and take on leadership roles to help the different student body with all this that goes on. There were 11 board of directors over the past year. And so a lot of them are not present here, but I'm going to read their names anyway because I want you to know who they are. They're a special group of people, and you guys as students need to make sure you tell them thank you before you leave, because they work tirelessly for all of you. Our fearless leader this year was Sarah Scott. She was the president. Our vice president who ran the career fair was Krista Burdan. They were both at the earlier service. Our secretary this last year was Grace Benskin. Grace, go ahead and stand. I see you back there. Grace is going to be the incoming president this next year. So when I call your guys' names, please stand up. Our incoming vice president for next year is Emily Aragon. Stay standing, Grace. No cheating. She was the community service director, and she's now going to be the vice president for this coming year. Last year, our treasurer was MJ Cheong. Our image of director was Madison Gallo. I don't think they're here. Amber Galligan, who graduated this morning, who got the Outstanding Academic Award, was our community health director. Felicia Ortega was the NSNA membership director. We had two different faculty liaison directors, each serving approximately 6 months out of the year. One was Samantha Armbruster, and the other was Nicole Moody. And then we had our merchandising director, excuse me, that was Dagny Drake. And then last but not least, we had our accelerated director, Molly Hamilton. Molly, you want to stand? So Molly, if you notice, the list of officers are on the back of your program. And if you notice, Molly's name is on there twice. She is there listed as this past year, and she's listed as the incoming year. But I want you to know Molly's going to graduate. We're not holding on to her as much as I'd like to. So she will graduate, and the new incoming accelerated class will elect a new accelerated director for this upcoming year for their cohort. So let's give them all a big round of applause.
Thank you, Sue, for your great leadership as the faculty advisor to that group that is very active throughout the year. Now, beyond the awards we just mentioned, our students have many accomplishments, and we'd like to highlight some of those for you. We first like to recognize our students who have served, currently serve, or are planning to serve in the military forces. Would you please stand? We recognize our students who have received a scholarship, either from UCCS or the Department of Nursing or the college, thanks to the generous support of our donors. Please stand. We recognize those students who have been inducted into a national or international honor society. To please stand. Now, we have an honor society for nursing, with our local chapter being the sci-fi chapter. We'd like to recognize our students who have been inducted into that honor society to please stand. We recognize all those students who worked in any way this past year with any service activity with the BSNA to please stand. And then we recognize the students who have excelled academically and achieved all these rigorous requirements in the program while balancing employment, family, and home. That's all of you. Please stand. Thank you all. Now it's the very special time of the ceremony, one that you've been waiting for, the actual pinning part of it that we're going to now begin with. It's now time for each one of these wonderful graduates to be recognized, not only by us, but also by family and friends who have significantly supported them and contributed to their success. Each graduate has chosen a special person to be present with them today. They're going to present them with a symbolic lamp of nursing pin. Now, the historical significance of the symbolic lamp dates, of course, back to Florence Nightingale. Florence Nightingale was the superintendent of the Hospital of Nurses, recruited during the Crimean War in 1854. And she carried a lantern when doing her nightly rounds of the 4 miles of wards of the military hospital. This vigilant and diligent watch over hundreds of wounded patients, added to the numerous other administrative responsibilities essential in the management of patient care, singled her out for respect and affection by the soldiers, who recognized her by the title, the Lady with the Lamp. The traditional symbolic lamps of nursing are not icons, but through custom, they represent something else for nurses: emblems of knowledge, compassion, and diligent vigilance. Now, the faculty presenters today are going to read your names. Will be Instructor Yvonne Young and Senior Instructor Susan Finke. So please follow the direction of Shelley over here. She's going to indicate your row to stand, and then you're going to proceed around to the right side of the stage.
Good afternoon. Okay. I guess they're going to come all the way around. I'll wait for them. Okay, first we have Grace Oschenberg, and her grandmother, Judy Oschenberg, will be pinning her. Great. Next we have Caitlin Baker. She will be pinned by her mother, who is also a nurse, Ingrid Leonard. Then we have Melissa Erin Burks, who will be pinned by her husband, Ken Morrow. And then we have Maria Katrina Chrysostomo, who is pinned by her spouse, Freddie Garcia. Then we have Megan Dalton, who will be pinned by her mom, Brenda Dalton. Next is Briar DeChant, who is pinned by her spouse, Paul DeChant. Next, we have Sawyer Ann Dickey, who will be pinned by her grandmother, Margaret Seagraves. Next, we have Brittany Dionisio, pinned by her mom, Stacy Dionisio. Next, we have Nita Duncan, pinned by her husband, Sky Duncan. Next, we have Alyssa Foreman, pinned by her significant other, Josh Kreitz. Andrew Gomez. All right. And he is being pinned by Sierra Gomez, his wife. And the very special Nico Farley, pinned by his dad, Jim Farley. Next is Molly Hamilton, pinned by her spouse, Joshua Hamilton. Next is Taylor Hargis, pinned by her father, J.R. Hargis. Next in line is Alicia Hawk, pinned by Maria Chrysostomo, friend and fellow nursing student. And then we have Morgan Jacobson, pinned by her spouse, Dylan Frick. All right, and then we'll bring up senior instructor Susan Finke.
Thank you. And now we have, oh,
glasses.
I would never forget your name. Garrett Krueger being pinned by his friend Aaron Mitcher. Hello. And next is Thomas Kuttner being pinned by his good friend Robert McKelvey. Next is Ashlyn Lewis being pinned by her mother Patricia Lewis. And Charity Dawn Lohr, pinned by Christopher Fries, her husband.
Good job.
And Mallory Martin, pinned by her friend Lizzie Grenridge. And Ashley Nokon, pinned by her mother, Jennifer Nokon. And Haley Overby, pinned by her mom, Donna Overby. And Colton Palmer being pinned by his fiance, Natalie Harkless. And Ryan Lee Ross Peltier being pinned by his grandmother, Betty Braunham. And Emily Pingleton being pinned by her husband, Joel Pingleton. Randy Presas pinned by her mother, Randy Presas. Tabitha Shermerhorn. Did I say it right?
Yes.
Pinned by her spouse, Kelly, Shermerhorn. So sorry. Sahuda Smith, pinned by her boyfriend, Philip Trion. Caitlin Sollier, pinned by her friend and nursing mentor, Megan Alferi. Lindsay Tatum, pinned by her mother, Jacqueline Tatum. Stevie Urban, pinned by husband, RJ Urban. And Chelsea Vincent, pinned by her husband, Stan Vincent. Nicole Whitehead, pinned by her significant other, Tony Goyer. And last, Tina Vigil, pinned by her husband, Ronnie Vigil.
Well, let's give them a rousing hand of applause. At this time, our graduates, like thousands of others before them, will recite the Nurses' Pledge. While this pledge has been updated to reflect contemporary nursing practice, the values expressed have remained constant since the beginning of modern secular nursing over 150 years ago. I also invite all of the nurses in the audience today to reflect on the words of the pledge, and if it feels right, to affirm your commitment to the profession. Molly Hamilton's going to come forward to lead the Nurses' Pledge. She's our BSNA Accelerated Director. So graduates, under your seat is a candle. So if you'll grab that candle and light that candle and stand. Now you'll find the pledge in your program as well as projected on the screen.
If you would please repeat the pledge with me. I pledge to care for my patients with all of the knowledge, skills, and understanding that I possess. Without regard to race, color, creed, politics, or social status, I will spare no effort to conserve life, to alleviate suffering, and to promote health. I will refrain from any action which might be harmful to the quality of life or health of those I care for. I will respect at all times the dignity and spiritual beliefs of patients under my care, and hold in all professional confidence all the personal information entrusted to me. I will keep my professional knowledge and skills at the highest level, engage in self-care, and support and cooperate with all members of the healthcare team. With full awareness of my qualifications, I will do my utmost to maximize the potential of the nursing profession and to uphold and advance its standards.
Please be seated. As chair of the Department of Nursing, I have the opportunity to provide you with some of our last words from faculty and staff at Johnson Bethel on behalf of the college, the department, faculty, and staff. I always look forward to graduation day, especially during this week following National Nurses Week, May 6th through 12th, with yesterday, May 12th, being Florence Nightingale's birthday. 2020, as you know, was designated the year of the nurse and midwife by the World Health Organization in honor of Florence Nightingale's birth year. But that was identified well before the pandemic became a reality. In retrospect, it was truly the year of the nurse in many ways. Nurses were confronted with immense challenges, and they met those challenges with grace and commitment to providing care to those in need. But we do want to pause and remember and honor those over 400 nurses who lost their lives this past year due to COVID exposure. Now, the experiences of patients, their families, and nurses during the pandemic are beginning to emerge in the literature. From patients and families experiencing COVID, these stories are frequently highlighting what is the essence of nursing: caring and compassion. Anecdotes of nurses providing a calming voice, being present with families who couldn't be with their loved ones, patients waking to a nurse holding their hand, or the nurse crying with the family following the loss of a loved one. These stories that are emerging in the literature highlight what it means to be a nurse. I would like to share a quote with you from Maya Angelou that I believe captures the meaning. As quotes, "I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel." These stories of nurses being simply present with compassion reinforce in us that this is what our patients and families will remember, how our care ultimately made them feel. Feelings of calm, feelings of presence, and feelings of protection. Another theme that's emerging in the literature, in the recent research that's been done over the past year, is the impact of the pandemic that's had on the healthcare workforce. Some common themes that are emerging there in the qualitative research are feelings of mental and physical exhaustion, which sometimes I'm sure you felt over this past year as well. Anxiety, frustration, concern over balancing commitments between work and family. You are entering a healthcare profession during a time that will surely have its challenges as we emerge out of this pandemic, but a time when you are valued and needed more than ever as part of a profession who has persevered during these daunting times. And we are so proud of you for your perseverance over this past year to complete your program requirements with the grace and fortitude you've showed. A recent qualitative research study exploring nurses' experiences during the pandemic identified a theme that I wanted to share with you today to keep in mind as you transition into practice. And the authors of the article termed that theme, and remember, qualitative research has themes, right, of all the interviews they do with their participants. And the theme that they saw emerging from these nurses was restorative self-care. Nurses were reporting these activities. They reported activities and self-care activities that they perceived were essential and getting them through the challenges of being on the forefront and on the front line every single day. So the important message here that I want to convey to you is to pay close attention to taking care of your own self-care first. participate in activities, and I know many of our faculty have had you do this over the past year, participate in activities that maybe invoke mindfulness, journaling, listening to music. Find positive relationships with your family, your friends, or pets. Exercise, or any other of a multitude of activities that provide you personal time and respite. Embodied each and every one of you is something more than just the knowledge, the skills, and the abilities that you've achieved over this past couple years to a year. You're more than just college graduates. You are Johnson Bethel nursing graduates. And you heard the history. You have a long history to uphold. And my hope is that each day you remember in your own special way how to convey your compassion and best practice in your patient care and ultimately promote your own self-care to restore your personal resiliency when you are confronted with challenges as you transition into practice. As graduates from Johnson Bethel, I believe that within each and every one of you is the power to change healthcare and to improve the health outcomes for our patients, the families, and the communities that we serve. Our faculty have made sure to prepare you well. But for now, relish in this excitement of this graduation weekend, or in August, your graduation. You've earned that. Today, or by August, you are nursing graduates, and we on the nursing department are so very proud of you. Keep in touch. We want to hear from you, and we want to hear of your exciting experiences in your next academic, and I'm sure most of you will go on to further academic achievements and practice achievements. So congratulations, and just have a wonderful journey in the nursing profession. So congratulations again to each and every one of you. We are so happy for you. This concludes our ceremony, and we look forward to hearing from you in the future.